Anthony Bourdain liked to say, walk in someone else's shoes or at least eat their food. And we got a taste of what he meant in his incredible storytelling. And in season after season of Parts Unknown, right here on CNN. So I want to bring in now CNN's Fareed Zakaria, host of Fareed Zakaria GPS. Fareed, thanks for joining us. It's a sad day for not only for CNN, but for really the world. Anthony Bourdain was so much more than a famous chef, but a man who found a way to make the world accessible. Case in point, Iran. Listen to this.
One last thing everyone's been telling me I have to try. Iranian takeout pizza.
It comes with ketchup.
What do you think about Iranian pizza?
Not bad.
Not bad.
We don't put ketchup on pizza, though.
I love ketchup.
So he went to eat pizza with a bunch of Iranian kids racing American cars in a parking lot. How many Americans could even imagine that scene in Iran?
Yeah, you know, he told me about that. And I think that what's extraordinary about that clip and his work in general is exactly what you said, Don, which is that he was much more than a great food writer, a great chef. He was a cultural ambassador. He was somebody who stumbled onto this role of trying to help Americans understand what seems a very foreign and alien world. You know, America is this vast continental nation with two vast oceans and, you know, two weak neighbors. We don't know much about the world. We don't travel that much. You know, famously, is a very small percentage of Americans have passports. And part of that is the result is then you begin to you fear, you're bewildered, and you can easily dehumanize people. And what Tony did was he really understood that the first challenge is to make people understand the other cultures, other people, just as human beings, with their own foibles, their own drama, their own sense of themselves. And he did it through food. But it was, I think there was a much larger mission. I don't know if he was doing it instinctively or whether he set out to do it. But he became one of the great cultural ambassadors America has ever had.
Yeah. You said that much more eloquently than I did. But when I was interviewed for the special that ran earlier, I said the same thing, how he took food and really transformed it. It wasn't really about the food. It was about the experience. And he taught people, like a journalist, and some better than some journalists. He was also fearless. In this episode in Moscow in May of 2014, he ate dinner with Boris Nemtsov, the former deputy prime minister and opposition figure. Listen to this.
Critics of the government, critics of Putin, bad things seem to happen to them.
Yes, unfortunately, existing power represent, let I say, Russia of 19th century, not of 21st.
Critics of Putin, beware. Oligarch Mikhail Khodorkovsky accused Putin of corruption and wound up spending 10 years in prison and labor camps. Alexander Litvinenko accused state security services of organizing a coup to put Putin in power. He was poisoned by a lethal dose of radioactive polonium. And Viktor Yushchenko, the former Ukrainian president, poisoned, disfigured, and nearly killed by a toxic dose of dioxin. I'm not saying official Russian bodies had anything to do with it, but it's mighty suspicious.
I don't think you need to be a conspiracy theorist to say whoever did this very much wanted everyone to know who done it. Everybody understands.
Yeah, of course.
And Fareed, of course, Nemtsov was murdered, gunned down in the streets about 9 months after that episode aired. And Anthony spoke out about that after it happened.
Yeah, it's another great example. Look, I had Nemtsov on my show, and I've watched that whole interview. Tony's is better because he was able to, again, communicate and reach people by using this vehicle of food, which disarms you, which just makes everyone feel that they share something in common. They share a love, a passion in common. But it didn't stop him, as you showed in that clip, from dealing with some very tough issues, some very hard issues. He dealt with it when he was looking at Indochina with the issue of unexploded American landmines. And I remember the New Yorker reported, this was when Obama and he had that dinner in Vietnam. The New Yorker reported that a lot of Obama's staff didn't realize the extent of this problem of American bombs that had been dropped in these countries that were still not had not exploded. And it may have had something to do with the fact that the administration then devoted $90 million to helping clean that up. So mm-hmm. No, there was some real substance there.
And Tony talked plenty about food and culture, but also he wanted to educate. In one episode from Houston, Fareed, he wanted to highlight the diversity there to show a side of the city many don't see. So he featured diverse immigrant communities, Indian, Vietnamese, Central American, African. He was trying to open people's minds. He did a very similar thing when he did his episode in the Bronx as well.
Exactly. It's as I say, the central theme of Tony's work has been make the foreign less foreign, make foreign people less foreign, make their cultures less foreign, and the vehicle was food, because we could, and in a way he was daring you to try and experience it, because if you remember so many of these episodes, he would try something weird, something that, you know, a lot of Americans would go into a restaurant and say, I'm not going to try that, I'm not going to try whatever it is, this exotic thing, and he would try it. And he would relish it, and his pleasure became contagious and was sort of an invitation to America to say, try and experience the world. Try to understand what it feels like, and you'll find all of a sudden it's not that foreign. Mm. Their fast food is like our fast food. Their love of their cuisine and culture is like our love of cuisine and culture. It's a very powerful, universal, humanizing message. You know, it really was something quite profound he was able to do using this very clever technique of just talking about food.